So, philosophy of education, we are in search for education for a better world. But on the other hand, sometimes you have to also zoom out and look at the big picture. And now today we are going, or this morning, we are going to zoom out about education. So not zooming in about asking questions, what's the better form of determination, is it multiple choice or open question? Also important, but today it's zooming out. Just find the part that we make several rounds, so we make pairs of three, and then you discuss, reflecting on your own education, what was inspiration for you.
Becoming critical and selecting what kind of knowledge is important. And although I think we agree that this last issue is a bit more important, to be a critical thinker and to question assumptions, I think it's also interesting that we brought in this issue that we do need some kind of flexible knowledge to be able to talk to one another.
So, what's happening to think big about education?
With adequate theories, hopefully you will teach new generation of students who will have impact in the future generations. That was our main point of teaching.
Thank you.
All these different aspects, the ethics, the coaching and the kind of human interaction, connecting ethics to strategy to knowledge acquisition, all these different things and to think about, to help students think about where do they fit in society, where do they want to be in all these different types of sectors, but how can they contribute to a change in the world.
I would be cautious to say this is definitely the right way of looking at things, so you should stick to what I'm saying is correct, because I think it's also the student has to develop their own sensibility and understand what is the moral compass that they want to have in their life.
Yeah.
In 10 minutes we will be back here, so just in rain, so find your own tree and see what it does to you or does not do to you. So enjoy for 10 minutes of quiet.
En hoe vindt u het, bomen knuffelen?
Het is ontzettend fijn om hier in het bos rond te wandelen. En ik geniet van de natuur, maar bomen knuffelen is niet helemaal mijn ding.
En waarom niet?
Ja, waarom niet? Waarom wel?
Nothing beats stopping for a moment and just kind of the busyness of everything about kind of going through life and then just settling down and being like, oh, this is also here. Yeah.
And you can, and like I heard, walking up front this line in the first round, I heard that nature does strange things to people or beautiful things to people that we don't understand completely yet. So this is the possibility to engage with nature and find your own relation with nature. So we have 10 minutes for that. I'll ring the bell at the start and at the end. It's 10 minutes because the first 5 minutes may be awkward in a way. So, and after that you may get used to being with a tree and you'll find out what happens, if anything. There's no goal, just be with a tree for 10 minutes. So I'll
maybe not hug the green ones because you wait too long.
Sure. You're sure?
Yeah, but you don't have to really closely embrace it.
Okay, 10 minutes.
We do this, we go all the way.
Jacob, could you maybe tell us why it's important to not only teach information and mm-hmm. skills, but also what you should do with it?
Yeah, okay. Yes, I think it's important that we do not only teach knowledge and skills to students, but that we also teach them how to behave in this world, how to be a democratic citizen, if you will. So in order to be in order to make it possible for students later on to have an important role in this world, it is important that they know what to do, but also how to behave, how to relate to other people, how to relate to people with other opinions, which is very important, I guess. And yeah, in that way make a more sustainable world together.
I was a bit hesitant in saying that I contributed to a sustainable world or a more sustainable world, but then somebody said, yeah, but your skills, or if we have the skills, the language skills to express ourselves, that also is very, very useful. So then I thought, oh well, okay, that's good.
Well, thank you. So Marco, could you react to the statement, thinking about sustainability makes me depressed?
Yeah, it makes me depressed. Yeah.
And why?
Because change is going much slower than we need. So I'm not so confident that we will change our behavior in time. So I'm worried, yeah.
And does it, they like today, help you regain some confidence?
No, absolutely not. No. We need so much more than a few nice colleagues. Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah. Thank you.
Sorry.